Hello all. In my previous video, we had solved the cases on finding the missing data of theodolite traversing. In that, we had seen length of bearing of same line missing as well as length and bearing of different lines missing. Now, we will solve the case 3, that is length of any two lines missing. Now, let us solve one example for this. In a traverse ABCDEA, the length of the sides DE and EA are missing. Determine the missing data. So these are the parameters that is given to us. Here, 5 lines are there, AB, BC, CD, DE, EA. And the length for AB, BC and CD is given. But for DE and EA, the length are missing. That is the case 3, length of any two lines missing. These two lines length are missing. And the whole circle bearing values are also provided for each line. So first we need to convert this whole circle bearing to reduced bearing. Now we know the conversion. This whole circle bearing is 99 degree. So 99 degrees in the second quadrant. So we'll have to subtract 180, this 99 from 180. So that will give us 81 degree 0 minutes. And it will be in the second quadrant, that is southeast. Then there is 31 degree 5 minutes. This is in the first quadrant. So first quadrant, the value will be as it is, 31 degree 5 minutes, and the direction will be northeast. This is 301 degree 20 minutes. So this value is in the fourth quadrant, that is northwest. So when we subtract this from 360 degree, we will get the reduced bearing. So that value comes out to 58 degree 40 minutes north west. Similarly, this 235 degree, it is in the third quadrant, that is southwest. So when we subtract 180 degree from this 235 degree, we will get the value as 55 degree 0 minutes, and it will be southwest, because it is in the third quadrant. Then 153 degree 25 minutes is in the second quadrant. So in the second quadrant, it is southeast. So when we subtract this by 180, when we subtract this value by 180, we will get it as 26 degree 35 minute, and it is in the second quadrant, that is southeast. Next, we have to calculate the latitude as well as departure. Now we know that latitude is L cos theta and departure is L sin theta. So here length is given as small l and reduced bearing is given as theta. Okay. So L cos theta will be 480 cos 81 degree. That value comes out to 75.09. And 480 sin 81 degree will give us 474.09. Next, 626 cos 31 degree 5 minutes. It will be 536.12. And here it will be sin 31 degree 5 minutes. So this will be 323.19. Next, it will be 470 cos 58 degree 40 minutes. This value is 244.41. And this will be 470 sin 58 degree 40 minutes. So this is 401.45. Okay, next value is, here let us denote this length DE as L1 and length EA as L2. So we need to find this L1 and L2. So L1 cos 55 degree. Cos 55 is 0.57 into L1. And here it will be sin 55 degree. So this will be 0.82 L1. Again here L2 cos 26 degree 35 minutes. So this will give us 0.89 L2. And this will be sin 26 degree 35 minutes. So this will give us 0.45 L2. Fine. Now you have to check the sine. So as this latitude is towards south, latitude will be minus. This is north, so plus. This is north, so plus. These both are south. So this both will be minus. Okay, here departure is towards east. So these both are plus. These two departures are towards west. So these both will be minus. Okay, this will be minus 401.45 and this will be minus 0.82. Okay, we need not consider this. It is minus 401.45. And this is east, so this will be plus. Now we have to find the summation for latitude, which will be equal to 0. So when we add up all these latitude values, what we will get? We will get minus 75.09 plus 536.12 plus 244.41 minus 0.57L1 minus 0.89L2. This all value will be equal to 0. So on solving it, we get this as 0.57L1 plus 0.89L2 will be equal to 705.44. Let us call this as equation number 1. We took this to the other side and we added these values, so we got this as 705.44. Next, we need to calculate summation of departure, which is equal to 0. So we need to add up all the departure values. So when we add up all the departure values, we will get 474.09 plus 323.19 minus 401.45 minus 0.82L1 plus 0.45L2 is equal to 0. So on solving this, we get the value as 0.82L1 minus 0.45L2 is equal to 395.83. Call this as equation 2. So we got two simultaneous equations, 1 and 2. On solving equations 1 and 2, we can solve it directly on the calculator as well. If we solve it directly on the calculator, we get value of L1 as 679.04 meter. And the value of L2, it comes out to 357.74 meter. Okay, so that is what we had to find out, L1 and L2. Hence, L1 is the length of line DE and L2 is the length of line EA. So this is length of line EA. This was what we had to find out. This was very simple. This case 3 is the simplest case from all the 4 cases. Okay, that is length of any 2 lines missing. Thank you.